Let me discuss the binary trees and the differences between these normal trees and binary trees. Right, binary. What do we know? What is a tree? Right, a tree is nothing but a collection of nodes and edges, where one node is represented as a root node, and the remaining nodes are considered as trees, and they are named as the subtrees. This is what we have defined in the previous slide, right? A tree is nothing but a collection of nodes and edges, where one particular node is specially designated as the root, and the remaining nodes are divided into different parts, which we call it as the subtrees, right? So, what do you mean by what do you understand by binary tree? We know what is trees, right? And we have to know what is this binary. Binary means, as the name suggests, it is by. We also come across this term called as binary in terms of operators. So while evaluating the postfix expressions, while converting the infix to postfix, we have come across an operator plus, star, division, minus, and exponentiation operator. All these operators are called as binary operators. Binary means it operates. You have to stress on this by. Those operators operate on two operands. That's the reason why it is called as by. By means two, right? Here also binary, that means there is something that is related to number 2. What is this relation? Just we'll discuss, right? So a binary tree is a finite collection of elements, which is similar to that of the definition of a tree. It is a binary tree, collection of elements, and a non-empty binary tree has a root element and the remaining elements are partitioned into binary trees. Right, we'll discuss. A non-empty binary tree has a root element. As discussed in the tree, every tree should have a node designated specially as root node. Similarly, here also in binary tree also we have a special node which is called as root node, right? And the remaining elements are partitioned into two binary trees, same as that of the definition of a tree, right? We have a number of nodes, and one node is root node, and the remaining nodes are divided and they are classified as subtrees, which are also binary trees. And this is important. The subtrees are called as left and right subtrees. In trees, we do not have any naming facility, right? We never mentioned that it is right child or it is left child or it is middle child. Like that, we never mentioned it. But if in case it is the case of binary tree, you have special names called as left child and right child, or left subtree or right subtree. So we are naming it. We are naming the left part of the node as left child, and we are naming the right part of the node as right child. Right. So this is the example we have. This is the binary tree, and as the definition suggests, that a binary tree with the following properties. This is very important. This is how we differentiate the tree and the binary tree. Right. In tree, we are specifying that each internal node has at most 2 children. We know what is this internal nodes, right? And he is specifying that every internal node should have at most. This term at most is important. At most means at most 2, means either it can have 0 children, or it can have 1 children, or it can have 2 children, right? All the nodes will have at most 2 children, right? And as you know, that children of a node are an ordered pair. Ordered pair means you can specify it as left or right. If you can specify it as left or right, we can say it as ordered pair, right? 1 minute. Now coming to the discussion part again, that is we call the children of an internal node as left child and right child. This is what we discussed, right? Most important points you have to remember is a binary tree is a tree which consists of a root node and which consists of the remaining nodes are divided into two categories, that is left and right. And one more important point, fourth important point is every node can have at most two children. At most two children means it's not two, it can have zero children, it can have one children, or it can have two children, right? If you consider this example, this binary tree, can it be a binary tree? Can we say that it is a binary tree? Yes. Why? Because it is a tree which consists of some different nodes and edges. Forget about it. And one node is specially designated as root. There is no need to mention that this node is root, right? Whatever node, a single node, if it is present on the top of the tree, that is treated as a root node. Therefore, the root node is A here. Next. A is having how many children? Two children. Is it satisfying this property? Every node should have at most two children, right? This is satisfying. Now come to B. How many children? Two. This is zero. This is two. This is zero. 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 One. Right? So every node is satisfying the property that at most two children is there. Right? Though we don't have this one, and we have the remaining nodes are all having the zero children or two children. Okay. And what is the third property? This particular part from B, it is called as left subtree, and this part CFG, this is called as right subtree. This is right and this is left, right? Since it is satisfying all these four properties, we call it as a binary tree. We call it as a binary tree. Most of the times, we will just check the number of nodes or the number of children for each and every node. If it satisfies the condition that all the nodes should have at most two children, then it is obviously a binary tree, right? So the applications of this binary tree are, we'll be using it in arithmetic expressions, which are called as expression trees. That concept also we'll discuss in the next coming slides, right? So these arithmetic expressions can be converted into binary trees. These arithmetic expressions, which are nothing but infix expressions, A plus B star C. This can be represented as a tree form like this. This is one node and this is another node. You connect it and this is plus and this is here. So you can represent a given arithmetic expression in the form of a tree, which we call it as expression trees. So that is one application. What is the need of this converting this given infix expression to expression trees? That we will discuss in the later classes. And it is also one of the application of binary tree is useful in decision processes, and it is useful in searching process. It's in case of BST, right? BST stands for binary search tree. This is one category of binary trees. So it is binary search. Binary search tree concept is very important according to gate point of view, right? And next, coming to this one. Now you can now tell me whether this is a binary tree or not, right? You have to check whether each node is satisfying the property that every node should have at most two children, right? So this is two and this is two, this is two, 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 zero, zero, zero. 2, 2, 0, 0, 0, 0. Since all nodes are satisfying the property of at most two children property, right? Therefore, this is a binary tree. And we have this left and right part. Every node will have left and right part, right? Similarly, this node is having this left part and right. What about this child? We assume that this is a null. And what about this child? Right part, again we assume that it is a null. So this is how we assume it, right? So the two children of each node are called as left child and right child. We know this point, and every node in a binary tree can have at most two children. This is satisfied, and the node can have only a left child or only a right child, or it can have no children at all also. If the node does not have any children, we call it with a special name called as leaf, right? Similarly, a node can have only the left child. Similarly, a node can have only right child. This is also possible, right? Or it can have two children like this, left child and right child, right? Or it can have no children like this. This is called as leaf. This is what he is explaining. And you can observe that what is the height of this binary tree? The height of this binary tree is you start giving the root as height 0. And this level is height 1. And this level is height 2. And this is height 3. Right? So the height of the given binary tree is 3 in this case. Right? Now coming to unbalanced trees. Balanced trees means the left subtree and the right subtree are having almost equal number of nodes. In such case, we call it as balanced trees, and there are some special definitions in the balanced trees. For example, AVL trees, it has some special definition. All those things we will discuss if it is in the syllabus, right? Only AVL trees is there in the syllabus. Therefore, we will discuss AVL trees concept, right? And what can you say about this unbalanced trees? Unbalanced trees means the number of nodes in the left child or the left number of nodes in the left subtree is much, much less than or much, much greater than the number of nodes in the right subtree. Therefore, there is no balance. There is no, the count in the left subtree, the count of the number of nodes in the left subtree is not equal to that of the, or almost equal to that of the number of nodes in the right subtree. In such case, we call it as an unbalanced tree. So here is the definition. It's not the definition, it's the best concept, right? So some trees are unbalanced. They have most of their nodes on one side. That one side can be either left or it can be right. Right. So their nodes are, most of the nodes are on one side of the root only, right? Next, coming to the next point, trees become unbalanced because of the order in which the items are inserted, right? So for inserting an element into the tree, there are some properties which should be satisfied in order to insert that particular element, right? It depends, or it varies from one tree to another tree, that we'll discuss. And if you insert elements while following those constraints, and if you observe that one particular end, either the left part or the right part, is increasing in a enormous fashion, then those trees are called as unbalanced trees, right? So the next point is, if the keys values are inserted in the ascending or descending order, then there will be an unbalanced. This we will discuss while you come across this binary history, right? So for set centric applications, binary tree and unbalanced tree must be rebalanced. This is very important, right? So this is one of the application. That is, if you want to perform any complex search operations, you cannot have this unbalanced trees. The unbalanced trees is not suitable for the search operations. So in such case, what you have to do is you have to rebalance it, rebalancing, right? That's what we discuss in the concept of AVL trees. Whenever you insert an element into the AVL tree, some of the nodes becomes unbalanced. What is this balance factor? All these things we'll discuss. Some nodes becomes unbalanced. So in order to make it balanced, you have to do some operations, or you have to perform some operations. That we will discuss in the AVL trees concept, right? So balanced trees are very much useful in the searching operation. This is what we have learned, right? Now coming to the types of binary trees. By looking at this slide, we will stop here. And types of binary trees. We have lot many binary trees, but the basic definition remains the same. The basic definition is, it is a tree where one node is designated as the root node and The remaining nodes are differentiated, are divided into two parts, that is the left subtree and the right subtree. And most importantly, every node in the binary tree should have at most two children. That means every node should have either zero children or one children or two children. This property is satisfied. If this property is satisfied, this is a binary tree, right? In addition to it, in addition to this constraint, that is every node should have at most two or at most two children. In addition to it, if there are some more properties that are satisfied, we call it with a different name. All right. So the first one is degenerate trees. Right. That is every node will have only one child. For example, you consider this tree. This node is having one right child, this node is having one left child, this node is having one left child, and this node is having zero children. It is satisfying the property of binary tree, right? Every node should have at most two children. That means 0, 1 and 2 children are accepted. This is perfectly a binary tree. But every node is having one child. Therefore, it is increasing in a linear fashion, right? It is increasing in such like this. Therefore, these type of trees are called as degenerate binary trees. Next, complete. Complete binary tree is a very important concept, very, very important concept, and you come across this concept under heaps. Heaps is also a very important concept, right? So, coming to the definition part of this complete binary tree, we can define the complete binary tree as a binary tree with some additional constraints. Already binary tree is a constraint, is consisting of some constraints from the tree definition. The constraint is every node should have at most two children. And if you put more constraints on the binary tree, then it can be treated as a complete binary tree. What is that constraint means? A complete binary tree is a binary tree in which all the levels are filled except the last level. All the levels, how many levels are there? This is level 0, this is level 1, this is level 2, right? All the levels may be filled, but the last level is not filled. If you want to fill the last level, you have to follow an order that you start filling the last level from the leftmost part only. Okay. For example, if you want to insert one more element in this or one more node in this binary tree. It is a binary tree, right? It is 2, it is 2, this is 2, and this is 0, 0. Number of children, no degree. If you want to insert a new node in the given binary tree, and if you want to say that it is a complete binary tree, or if you want to say that it is following the constraints of the complete binary tree, in such case, what you have to do is, you cannot insert the new node as the right child like this. You cannot insert the left child. You cannot insert like this. All these things are not accepted in complete binary tree. In complete binary tree, he is saying, the definition is saying that you have to start filling the new level from the leftmost part only. What is the leftmost? This is, you go to the left hand side, right? This is the leftmost node. And that too, you have to fill it as the left child only. You cannot take the leftmost node and you make it as the, make the new node as the right child. You have to make the new node as the left child of the leftmost node, right? And if you want to insert one more node, then the right child of the leftmost node is not filled, therefore you have to fill it here, right? Right, I think you got it. Now you add one more node, the node that is beside the leftmost node is this node, right? You have to fill the node as the left child of this particular node. Next node, this one. Next node, this one. Next node, this one. This one. Right. So it is a binary tree which also have one more constraint, that while filling the last level of the binary tree, you should follow the rule that you should always start ever filling the nodes from the leftmost node only, leftmost part only. That's the meaning of complete binary tree. So this is very important, complete binary tree definition. And coming to balanced binary trees, right? Here we have for the root, if you take the root, the left child is having two nodes and the right child is having three nodes. It's like something like balanced only, not exactly that every node should have exactly n number of nodes in the left child and exactly n number of nodes in the right child. Even we have some one or two nodes difference can be accepted. Even then also we call it as a balanced binary tree. But if you consider this one, you take the root, how many nodes in the left child? Left is 0, right? And how many nodes in the right side? 1, 2 and 3. It's unbalanced, right? So degenerate trees, and we have some more concepts called skewed binary trees. This is also an unbalanced tree. So if you take this A, you take this root node in this diagram, this is A, how many nodes are there in the left child? 1, 2, 3 and 4. How many nodes are there in the right child? It is 0, right? So this is how it is done. So this is a example of unbalanced tree. And coming to this example, this is called as skewed binary tree. Skewed binary tree means you will have the growth of the binary tree in only one direction, right? All the nodes will have only left child, or else all the nodes will have only right child. If every node is having the left child, it is called as left skewed binary tree. Left skewed binary tree. Similarly, this one, this is having the children only in the right part, therefore it is called as right skewed binary tree. Right, so left skewed binary tree and right skewed binary tree, these are the different things. And complete binary tree we have discussed in detail, right?